Harmonic balance is a frequency domain analysis technique for calculating the steady state response of nonlinear circuits. In this video, we're going to conduct a one-tone harmonic balance simulation. Internally, the simulation starts with KCL in the frequency domain and a number of harmonic frequencies. The number of frequencies is called the order of the simulation. Since it is a frequency domain analysis technique, harmonic balance simulation is best used to analyze power amplifiers, frequency multipliers, mixers, oscillators, and modulators. Here I have a sample BJT amplifier. The amplifier is expected to have around 12 dB of gain at 2 GHz. We want to perform our harmonic balance simulation to see its performance under different input powers. I'll quickly push into the hierarchy so we can take a look at the amplifier provided. Note that we have four pins. Pin 1 will be our RF input, pin 2 will be our RF output, and pin 3 and pin 4 will be biases. In advance, I've set up the biases for this component. These are not important for understanding the harmonic balance. For our harmonic balance simulation, we first need to place a one-tone power source. This component can be found in the source's frequency domain palette. We'll place it on the RF input side of our component. The frequency parameter is the fundamental frequency that will be tested. In this case, we need to have a 2 GHz fundamental, since we want to see the amplifier's gain at that frequency. We'll come back later to see what we need to set the power to. Let's switch to the simulation HB palette and place a term component. We need to terminate the RF output and place a label for measurement later. Now we need to define a variable for the power of our input. Go to Insert VAR and place it on the schematic. We'll double-click on the VAR, change the variable name to PIN, and set the value to negative 10. We'll use this variable again later to define the power sweep. Let's now set the magnitude of the power for the single frequency source. We'll change the magnitude to Pn, which we've already defined to be negative 10 in the variable. As with any other simulation, we need to place a controller. In the same palette, choose the HB simulation controller. We'll set the fundamental frequency again to 2 GHz and keep the order at 5. Now we have a circuit that is ready for a harmonic balance simulation. Press F7 to begin simulation. Let's plot the dBm of Vout, add a rectangular plot, and add Vout to the traces. We want to see the spectrum of Vout in dBm. If we want to see the precise value of the dB at 2 GHz, we can add a list. Click the list icon, and under equation, type dBm of Vout bracket 1. This will give you the dBm of array index 1 of Vout. Note that the 0th index is at 0 GHz. Note we have 2.115 dBm at 2 GHz. As expected, this is a 12 dB gain from the input power of negative 10 dBm. Let's now do a power sweep simulation for this amplifier. To keep the simulation from the previous example, we're going to make a copy of the simulation cell. From your main window, right-click on HB Simulation, Copy Cell, and make a new cell called Simulation Sweep. Let's open the schematic. We'll double-click on the controller to open up the settings. Go to the Sweep tab. Under Parameter to Sweep, enter PN. This will tell the controller to sweep the variable PN that we created earlier. This in turn will sweep the power of the single tone source for RF input. We'll start at negative 10 dBm and sweep until 6 dBm. Let's simulate again. We'll place a plot of V out. We want to sweep over the fundamental tone 2 GHz in dBm over the entire sweep. This generates a plot of P in sweep against the dBm of V out. The gain of the amplifier will be the dB of the output voltage minus the input power, also in dBm. To write this using ADS functions, we'll define gain equals the dBm of Vout :, (1) minus Pn. Note that I've specified Vout :, 1. This means the whole sweep of Vout at steps of 1. We again add a rectangular plot and specify the y-axis to be the gain equation that we just wrote. Now we can see the gain of the amplifier over a range of input power. Thank you for watching this Keysight ESOF EDA tutorial. You can find a link to a free trial of ADS in the video description below.